And welcome back. This is your RPG Chick, and this is Pillars of Eternity. Now, these guys aren't guarding this gate, so let's just see if we can get in here.
This won't stop me from locking.
Who's unlocking it? What? No. Send.
What? A simple test.
Yeah, send this.
That's settled.
Yeah.
Huh. We leveled up. Can we close this? Oh. We're not seen. Somehow. This is the one that keeps opening and closing. Well, these guys are stupid. They're guarding this one. And where in that one? They don't see us. Oh, game, you're cheating in our favor. Alright, I guess they don't see us. Let's level up. Oh, not a dare yet. I want him to level up. Because I want to check that out. God, look at that. He needs 53 points. 45,000 points. 53 points to 45,000. Alright, Aloth. I want to figure out his frickin' weapon focus and weapon specialization or whatever the hell. Should we take lore for him? Let's take lore. I kind of want to be high in lore. Does someone else have high lore? Let me just because what I'm thinking. Six. I think Palagina is very high, Laura. Is she? Oh, five. Aloth, nine. Durance, four. Adair, one. Kanna is nine. How about make Aloth our lore specialist? Because Kanna I'm going to trade out now and then for other party members. Don't get me wrong, I love Kanna, but I love these guys more. Just a tiny bit more. So, I have not really leveled anyone up in lore. But since this game is steeped in lore, I should, right? So, Aloth is 10. Lore 10. Level 5 spells. Wow, I gotta check this out. Archimere's Wondrous Torment. Drains the target's resolve and intellect, creating two less powerful versions of the effect that jump to nearby enemies when the first effect ends. Minus 10 resolve, 10 intellect for 13 seconds. I'm not going to do that. Call to Slumber. Causes a group of enemies to momentarily fall asleep, going prone for a short duration. For 13 seconds versus Will. Sidzal's Spirit Lance. Creates a pike of pure magical force that deals pierce damage and causes a foe-only blast explosion like wands do. Oh, so you're summoning a weapon. So you still have to use it. Lengrath's Safeguard. An insidious magical contingency activates when the caster hits 50% endurance. He or she immediately knocks all... Immediately... Very, a lot of immediately stuff going on. Close enemies prone while gaining a damage reduction and defense bonus for a short time. That's pretty cool. Is this passive? Or do I have to cast this on me at the beginning, like before I hit 50%? I never noticed the stripy pants. Look at that. Stripy pants. Like spandex or something. Plus 20 all defenses. I'm not sure about this, how this works. It would be nice if this was a passive ability, but it's a spell, so I'm going to have to cast on myself. Okay. Malignant Cloud. Generates a cloud of virulent poison, inflicting raw damage to anyone in the cloud every few seconds. 16 to 23 raw versus fortitude. 13 seconds. Ninagoth's Bitter Mooring. The target is hit with the stuck affliction and becomes an anchor for a frigid ray of energy from the wizard that does freeze damage to enemies in its path. Target 21 to 30 freeze. Stuck for, well, basically 4 seconds versus fortitude. A beam. 21 to 30 freeze. It doesn't say foe, but it does say enemies in its path. Stuck for 4 seconds. Okay. It sounds promising. I mean, I want to make sure it is enemies, though, not... It doesn't say foe. You know, it only says foe. This isn't foe AoE, but foe beam or something. I don't know. Torrent of Flame. Instantiates a terrifying inferno of flame around the caster, inflicting burn damage on everyone around. So it radiates out. Yeah, radius. Nice. 42 to 58 burn versus reflex. Fast casting. Good for if you get stuck and, you know, isolated from the group. Otherwise, it's going to hit everyone, because we're usually guarding him. Oh, that's it. Wall of Force. Creates a semi-permeable barrier that inflicts crush damage and hobbles enemies when they pass through it, but leaves allies unscathed. Ooh, I like that. I actually like that. Much better than the Wall of Fire, which will damage enemies and has done so, which is why I've only cast the thing like once or twice. 4-6 crush hobbled for 26 seconds versus 4-2. Now hobbled means your dexterity is reduced by 2, movement by 1.5, and reflex by 20. Nice. And then what you really want to do, once the reflex is reduced, then you cast spells on them that require a reflex save. Which I think would be anything physical, right? Or I could take another one of these. Aloth duplicate. How much shock damage, though? Doesn't say. I want to get another magic missile upgrade. Or, concussive missile, whatever they call it. Yeah, see? Versus reflex, stuff like that. So first he'll cast that, people get hobbled, and then he'll throw fireballs at them. And all that fun stuff. Yeah, I gotta take that. That looks pretty helpful. I mean, the crush damage isn't so much. It's, you know, really the icing on the cake. It's the hobbled thing I like. I can take one, okay. What, I go back instead? Okay, take another thing. I should take that. Grimoire Slam, just to knock people back. Hardened Veil. That's neat too, though. That's 2 per rest. This is 1 per encounter. Penetrating Blast. Concentrates the power of Blast, negating some of the target's damage reduction. What constitutes a blast? Is a fireball a blast? You'd think it would be, right? Or I could take a bonus 4th level spell. Do I want a 4th level spell? Flame shield. Plus 10 damage reduction. Retaliate when hit by a melee attack. Well, how much? How much does it hit him for? I'm gonna take Remora Slam. There's a lot of good ones. I mean, I could also take this thing that increases your fire damage. Yeah, I'm so... I don't know. Maybe I'll take that next time. Remora Slam, though. For some reason, I feel like that's a have-to-take kind of thing. Can't believe this person doesn't see us at all.
All right, then.
Ooh, neato. Water drips from the edges of the alcove. Ooh. The Enigmatic God of Cold. I'll just read this right now. Young students are often confused by Barath and Rimmergand, Rimmergand's seemingly overlapping roles in holding dominion over death. Barath oversees the cycle of life, death, and rebirth. Rimmergand oversees the cold, destructive act of death itself. This difference is often difficult for novices to appreciate until they've lost a loved one and endured the absence for a time. It is Barath that determines we will be reborn just as certainly as we will die. But Rimmergand is the executioner's axe. Rimmergand shows us that all life ends in stillness. Well, if we're reborn, then all stillness ends in life. I need only show them the symbol of Rimmergand, the bone-white auroch skull found carved within the most ancient Ingwithin ruins. It is a symbol of death and doom in every culture. Any child with 4 winters under his belt needs no introduction to the ancient symbol. Rimmergand embodies not just death, but all manifestations of collapse, be they famine, plague, or simple bad luck. Alright, we gotta level up Canna too. Rimmergand is a primal god, silent and inscrutable as death itself. He makes himself known with his passing, not by proclamation. There are innumerable stories of the god's terrifying passage through the lands of Eora. When the beast of winter stirs, bitter winds and beastly howling follow the creature's every move. Wherever the beast plants a hoof, all life withers into dust. The faithful of Rimmergand insist that even another god's life can end in stillness. They claim the other gods must flee from the beast of winter's mastery over death, but we know not if this boast holds true. Though the beast of winter is shrouded in snowy clouds, those who have seen the shaggy white monster claim that the souls of the fallen can be seen clinging, or perhaps frozen, to the beast's fur. The dwarves of the boreal south have numerous stories that tell a similar plot. A brash hero seeks out the beast of winter to rescue the souls trapped in its fur. These tales never end well, for even if the hero saves his beloved soul, the hero dies in the process, for it is not a proper tale of Rimmergand unless the hero's life ends in stillness. That's depressing. Let's hope this guy doesn't see the door open and is like, what the hell? I'm supposed to open the door. Alright, let's see. Give him... athletics. I still don't know how to use this crap. I'm so lazy with looking up things, guys. I'm just kind of want to play the game. Let's pick a good one, though. Calls down a drake from the skies to fight for the party. That's a good one. I really gotta learn how to use this stuff. Only if you have to put it on the little... to make a phrase out of it first, I think. I'm not sure, like, how to click it to, or, you know, if I gotta drag it onto that. Summons two fearsome ogres to fight for the party for the duration. Yes. The drake is gonna be impressive, though. Revives allies in the area of effect with a small amount of endurance. Requires five phrases chanted. Oh. So I gotta chant a certain amount of phrases and then get up to that. Crap. So less for 30 seconds. That's a long amount of drake. But of course we have to chant five phrases and then summon the drake. So that's gonna be a long battle to do that. Attacks enemies in seven directions around the chanter with bolts of freezing ice. Foe target. Well, that one's good too. Empowers allies in the area of effect with bonuses to dexterity, perception, and intellect. Plus five for all. And empowers allies in the area of effect with bonuses to might, constitution, and resolve. Plus five to all. Okay, I'm taking this, the drake thing. Yes! Now I gotta learn how to use it. Beloved spirits. This is a talent. Improves the chanter's connection to the soul fragments they employ, increasing ancient memories' healing capability. He uses an Estoc. I might have given him weapon focus already. One-handed style. Converts 30% of grazes to hits. Oh no, this is two-handed. Plus 15% damage. That's good. I'm not sure if I use this offhand. So I'm gonna take two-handed style. He said stop for a second, he's like, the door's open. Crap! Trespassers in the inner halls, he says. Are they all gonna burst in here and attack us now? And I hope this doesn't make the whole town attack us, and we're just looking for this girl. I guess if we have kept them over here... I thought he couldn't see us at all. I mean, we were standing right in the hallway, he was walking right past us. Now he sees us. Let's hope he doesn't bring any of his friends. I took that? necrotic lance. Burning stuff. Are they coming?
Too long has it been since we made camp.
Sneak, people! Sheesh. Okay, hopefully they won't be looking for us. Water drips from the edges of the alcove. Silver key! Covered in a thin layer of silver. That would make it a silver key. Well, it would have been done in here.
No problem.
Hey, you guys didn't say this door. Alright. Let's see if anyone else comes, if we can avoid them. Oh, they know we're here. He knows we're here.
Yes?
That's not very helpful.
Can you reach it there?
Hey.
That's not very helpful.
Keeping an eye out.
Yeah.
Okay, we've been there. We'll continue on this way. Trap detected.
And the fire shows me something new.
There must be something going on here that they're so secretive. Yay, lockpicks! Can we undo this? From there? Wow, you're really talented. A scroll of Maelstrom and a potion of mirrored image. Potion of mirrored image, I don't remember it looking like that. A wizard's double. Maelstrom. Probably combine some of these. I should really do this off screen though. Looky that. Okay. Okay, there's a door, and there's, well, nothing. No secret here? Secret opening? Unlock with the silver key, hell yeah. Oh, there's Alwa! A young Orlin scrambles on the stone floor, pressing her back against the wall and baring her teeth at you. Her fur is patchy and matted. As you step into the room, she squints and turns her large ears toward you. A heavy sigh escapes her tiny body. Beast, take me. My eyes mistook you for one of them. Please get me out of here. What happened to you? When Noonfrost began freezing the lake, my sister Lara sent me to seek out the cause. She scowls at the dingy room. The pale elf Estramorin sees me before I could report back. These pale elves are behind it. They showed up in Twin Elms not long ago, saying they wanted to see to the upkeep of Noonfrost. Huh. Well, maybe the Glanfathans will be happy that we deal with them. I don't know how, but they open the frost-hewn breach at the back of the temple, sucks warmth and life straight into the frozen god's barren domain. She shivers. They've got to be stopped. It's only a matter of time before the cold spreads further. Can you tell me anything about the frost-hewn breach? She shakes her head. Not really. Something to do with Rimmagan, the Beast of Winter. I follow Galloway myself. Can you tell me something about the people that captured you? She snarls, her pointed teeth flashing. A clan of pale elves from the White That Wends, devotees of Rimmagan, or so they claim. Their actions suggest other intent. They've come ready to fight. Wizards, priests, and paladins. A wizard named Glasval leads them, a man obsessed with the frost-hewn breach. My ears hear him through the wall, casting spells and calling upon strange powers. I don't know what he wants with it, but no good can come of it. It isn't safe yet. Wait here until I clear a path. Literally. She eyes the door longingly and shivers again. Please hurry. I found Awa locked in a room near the back of Noonfrost. She told me that the Glamfellen captured her when they caught her sneaking around. She wants me to help her escape. Told her it wasn't safe to leave yet. It won't be good for either of us if the pale elves catch her escaping, so I'll have to clear a path or find some way to negotiate with their leader. Oh, really? I can? However, it doesn't seem like they're inclined to let me see him. Well, I'll clear a path to the leader, or clear a path through everybody. These bronze manacles gleam with frost. Well, at least they didn't use them on her. Though cold to the touch, these manacles are free of ice. Please, I've got to get out of here. I haven't eaten more than a mouthful of ice in days. Sounds appetizing. We will do what we can. We haven't been through that door. Spooky sounds. Spooky sounds.
Eyes open.
Hello!
This is here!
Well, yeah, I gotta wait for the gate to open, then we'll end it here.